Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about goods and service tax. This is the most important topic and it is the most discussed topics everywhere. So we will also discuss about this GST. So before going to GST, you should know about the taxes. Okay, there are two types of taxes, like direct tax and indirect tax. Direct tax means it is from people to government. Example is income tax. You are paying directly to the government, right? In indirect tax, example is service tax. If you are going to a restaurant, you can see the service tax. Because from people is giving to the hotel owner and he will pay to the government. So, there is a middleman involved. So, this is indirect tax. So, know the difference between these two taxes. So, the history of GST. The main thing to be noted here is GST is not evolved or discovered by the BJP government. It has been in talk for many years in India. And the bill has been formulated by the earlier Congress government. And the BJP is now implementing it with many amendments. Okay, that is the main thing you should note here. And some points about GST, all the existing indirect taxes. I told about the indirect tax. When a middleman is involved, it is called indirect taxes. So, all the indirect taxes which has been named in India will be subsumed under a single tax. Okay. So, these service taxes, sales tax, you can't find this anymore because GST will replace these all indirect taxes. Okay. So, the theme of this is one nation, one tax. Okay. I hope you can know about this. It came into effect, as you all know, by July 1, 2017. And it is a modified VAT. Here comes the clearance. Okay. GST is a modified VAT. Something called value added tax. So, what is this value added tax? We'll see in detail. So, transmission of GST. So, we'll see what is value added tax. Okay. For example, you take a pen. Okay. The pen is, a paint will be involved in that pen making. Okay. So, if you say there are many stages of production. So, if manufacturer is painting that pen and it will be taxed. The paint of the pen will be taxed. Okay. It will be go to next stage. Like for distributor. Okay. There also the paint is again taxed. It will go to next stage for consumer. There also it will be taxed. So, this paint of the pen is multi-taxed. Okay. This is called cascading effect in terms of economy. Okay. To solve this problem, because the paint has been taxed in every stages and finally the value of the paint becomes higher. Okay. To solve this problem only, the government came with something called value added tax. Okay. So, what is the difference between VAT and GST is, GST is not a new concept actually, because VAT has been implemented before itself. VAT has been in circulation before itself. Central government used this VAT system for finished goods and state government is using for services. Because you can find, if you are going to hotel, you can find something called VAT, because state government is implementing only for services and central government for finished goods like excise duty. Okay. So, now the difference is this VAT is now being used everywhere. Before state government used for only services and central government only for finished goods. Now this GST everywhere. Okay. So the difference is same tax for the country. Okay. Everywhere if you go to Pondicherry or Delhi, the tax will be the same. Okay. That is the difference between the VAT and GST. The point should be noted here is GST is not a fresh concept. Earlier it is called VAT. Now it has been transformed as GST. Okay. So how GST works? We will see with an example. As I already told, a pen. Okay. You fix the tax as 10%. Okay. That's normal tax. Okay. Now we'll see what happens before GST and after GST. So in this before GST, I told four stages of production: manufacturer, distributor, wholesale, retail, and consumer. Okay. So now manufacturer. Okay. He's buying a raw material to make this pen. He's buying raw material for 50 rupees and he's adding some 50 rupees for his profit. Okay. So finally the product's cost becomes 100. Now for this 100, he should pay a tax. I told fixed tax for tax is 10%. So on this 100 means 10 rupees. So, the value of the product becomes 110. Now, it goes to distributor. He adds some 10 rupees and the value becomes 120. On this 120, he will pay some tax. 10% means 12. So, 132. Like this, the process goes on and finally, it ends up with the consumer. MRP becomes 192.8 for that pen. We will assume. Okay. This is before GST. So, after GST, what's happening is, now we'll see. The same manufacturer only, he is buying 50 rupees raw material. Okay. So, he is adding 50 rupees profit. Okay. So, the value becomes 100. Now, what the difference happened in this is, for this 50 rupees is adding, no, for that only he will pay the tax. 10% means 50 on 50 means 5 rupees. He will pay tax to the government, not for this entire 100 rupees. Earlier, for this entire 100 rupees, he paid a tax of 10 rupees. Now, for the only thing he added, he is paying tax. Now, I hope you know about the concept of value added tax. This is the value added tax because 50 rupees is the only value added by him. For that only, he is paying tax. So the value of the product doesn't change. It remains at 100 only. Okay. Now here see distributor is adding 10 rupees. For that only he will pay tax, not on this 110. Okay. This is the difference you should know. Okay. for this 10 only, he'll pay taxes. So the price becomes same only, 110. Like this, it goes on, and consumer, when it reaches the market, the price is 148.2. Earlier you see the price, 192.8. You can see the difference. That is difference of GST. Earlier it was higher, and after GST, the price becomes lower. Okay. So there are many rate slabs for GST. As you all know, you have read in newspapers and all. So there are 0, 5, 12, 18 and 28. There are 5 slabs. And 0 and 5 for essential goods, like normal daily use goods. And for 12 and 18 for normal commodities. And 28 for luxury goods, like tobacco, cars and all. These are luxury items. Like, this comes under 28% tax. Also, I told, when GST is implemented, the state will face huge revenue loss. To compensate that, they are coming with something called GST cess. Okay. It will be applicable over and above the rates for a period of 5 years to compensate the revenue loss of the states. Okay. Something called GST cess will be applied on this slab, 28% slab, and from that the money will be collected and it will be given to the states as a compensation. Okay. So we will talk about the what are the GST what are the prices. Okay. There are many prices which becomes expensive and which becomes cheaper. So eating out and phone bills, small cars, all becomes expensive, and what will become cheaper is your branded clothes, big cars, heater, air coolers, painters, cements. These things will become cheaper. Okay. So there are many components in GST, like central GST, state GST and integrated GST. Central GST is levied by the central government. As you know, in polity you have studied about central list, state list and integrated list. Okay. The same thing is here. In central GST, central government will levy and it will collect. In state GST, state government will levy and it will collect. So what about this integrated GST is, the central government will levy and collect. What does integrated means? If you assume, in state means, in inside Delhi, they are goods being transferred, means the Delhi state government will take the charge. Now what happens is, a good is transferred from Delhi to Tamil Nadu, means then central government will come in and central government will levy the tax. This is about the integrated GST system. Okay. So tax rate for this CGST and SGST should not exceed 20%. And for this integrated GST, it should not exceed 40%. Okay. So we'll talk about GST council. I told earlier about the 4 tax slabs. Okay. This GST council only came with that proposal of fixing the tax slabs and all. So what is this GST council is? It will comprise of all the state finance minister or representatives. Okay. Either finance ministers or representatives from every state, and it will be headed by the finance minister. Okay. So it will meet frequently at every month, and it will decide about the tax rate slabs. And hence they came with something called the, I told about the 5 slabs, right? So this GST council only came with that slab. So whether government can change the tax slabs, it can change, but the approval of GST council. Only if GST council is thinking to change the slab rates, only the central government can do that. Okay. So finally, whether it's a win or lose, that we should wait and see, because in economic surveys they have mentioned that slow term, in the short term there will be a loss, or the GDP of India will be going to a trash, but later on it will regain. Okay, this is the point they have covered in economic survey. So we should wait and see whether the GST game is winning or lose. I hope you get some understanding or clear concept about this GST. Thank you.